Well, the easterlies, they continue. Well, as you can see, I've made a start on the front wheels of the undercarriage of this cart. Obviously, you've seen me re-glue two pieces back in that were just wedged in around a spoke, and then filling that side, obviously, and giving it an undercoat, sanding it back and giving it an undercoat. I've had to go out and get some metal primer because I actually primed a bit of the metal on the other side and the rust still bled through. Obviously it's obviously you've got to use the metal primer, the enamel based one. So then I flipped that wheel over and I got the other one prepared as well, which didn't have any gluing in. I've just got a lot of bulk filling into there. And then the other side of this, there are chunks that are out of it that I don't have the pieces that were there, they're just lost. So I'm not gonna go and try and fit any kind of piece of little bits of timber in there. I'm simply going to bog all that, sand it all back and prime that as well. Trying to determine how I'm going to what I'm going to do with the steel. My first thought was to grind all the surface rust back off, prime it and paint them black. A lot of the ones out there you see that they just remain rusty looking steel belts around them, but I don't know, I think they need to be painted. It'll wear off eventually, and it's not going to get moved much, this car, but it'll probably wear off over the years, but I'm sure it'll last for quite a while and gonna look good with the black, if they're black. I've zeroed down a color scheme and you'll see that as I apply the first coat. I hope it's the right choice. It's partly traditional, but it may not be the color that people were expecting, but it's what I like. It is a big job though. It's most definitely time consuming. It's quite an involved project. It's different, it's fun, I like it. We'll continue on. Unbelievable, this wind. We've now passed 2 full months in 2022, and I reckon I could count less than 10 days where we did not have wind for the entire 2 months, all easterlies. I've had to actually put up shade cloth barriers, big fencing panels, just to stop the wind howling through here. Anyway, these two front wheels have proven to be quite a bit of work, mainly of filling. And as you can see, there is a substantial amount of filling on one of the wheels, not so much on the other. It's a bit of a drawn out process doing all this. I'm very thankful that the back two wheels have nowhere near the damage or whatever that these front two wheels have, so I'm hoping they go a lot quicker. And when I get them done, I'll move on to all of the other timbers, which are all in pretty good condition, so just need paint prepping and then painting. Quite the project.